virus to death. Dude. Like Contagion, yup.
World War Z in your face,
bro. Brad Pitt, save us.
Please. All right. Hello and welcome back to On the Rail, the number one EDM podcast on the line. It is March 3rd, 2020, and we're still on tour. My name is Victor. This is Vince.
I would fuck up zombies in World War Z.
World War Z, it, honestly, I think apocalypse like that would kind of be dope. Very scary. Wouldn't want it to happen, but...
If I knew in advance and I had time to gather necessary equipment and supplies, oh yeah.
It's really crazy that people were talking about World War III, and then it just literally disappeared. It's like,
yeah,
like,
never mind, forget it.
It's crazy.
Wow.
All right, well, this past weekend I was on tour, and we had a really good weekend. We went to Houston, Dallas, or we went to Dallas, then Houston, and then EDC Mexico.
Nice.
EDC Mexico on Sunday was massive, dude. I was shocked at how big it was. It's way bigger than EDC Las Vegas, and I thought that was really surprising.
Yeah, that is surprising. I wouldn't expect that. I thought EDC Vegas was like huge, all-time numbers.
Yeah.
I guess Mexico does it a little bit bigger.
We walked from like all the way side to side, and I don't know, maybe it was just because like I was really tired, but the walk felt like it took forever.
Is that how you
and
measured honestly, the crowd by walk?
Yeah.
All right, good call.
But there was a lot of people. I don't know. It just seemed bigger than, like, the ground side seemed bigger than Las Vegas.
Yeah,
I was running on very little sleep. And
really? I couldn't tell.
Earlier that day, I ran 7 miles. And, like,
dude,
it
got
was
back,
way too
you
much.
You were so tired from tour. When you got back, you were talking how people type Morse code. Like, I was in tour. Stop. I'm at the apartment. Stop.
My brain was functioning at like a 7.5%.
Your brain was stop and go traffic, dude. It was brutal.
It felt brutal. It was not great.
Oh, man.
All right. The videos this week. So when you go to a rave, you're enjoying the music. You're having fun, right?
I am. All right. That's the mood.
But
I'm there.
One of the best parts of the rave is the girls, right?
Yeah, no, it's good.
What is your favorite rave bay? So roll this clip right here. Here are some of the options.
Choose your character.
Dude, you know, here's my thing, right? I like to dance. I think that's fair to say.
Yeah.
We like to dance.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So shout out Ariana, Gabby.
Yeah. Yeah.
We like people that like to dance.
Yeah.
Guys,
have
girls,
fun.
Whoever. The awkwardly not electronic music, Tame Impala, but kind of. Tame Impala, that was the most fun I've had in a crowd
so
in a very long time.
Yes.
She asked me the type of girls that I hang out with at festivals. That's the kind.
The ones who dance.
Gotta move.
Yeah. I'm a big fan of the rave moms.
I'm not a big
the ones
PDA
who, like,
guy.
Keep it all in check, you know? Always taking care. Always
We've
giving out water.
We've talked about it before on pod, but ease up on the PDA at festivals.
Good
it's
point.
Too hot.
Yeah.
Usually it's too hot for that shit.
Next video we got up is a guy using all his resources. Using all his resources, using everything he can to get with this girl. Roll this clip right here. Some would say that this is a live look
Pod
at
only?
Vinny at a
giving
club right
Victor
now.
The finger. Listen, one, now that my chiropractor made me taller, this is not me, so... It's an outdated joke. Update your fucking references. But two, I've seen this before, dude. It's brutal. Like, dude, play the height you are. I don't care what the music, what festival you're at, what club you're at. Play the height you are. It's never, ever worth it to fucking embarrass yourself rocking the stair game. It's just never.
Yeah, it's pretty tough.
It's never. It's just because always someone that can't. Dude, what are you going to do? Cut the staircase out and carry it around with you the rest of your life. It's like Costanza and the Timberlands, bro. You just, it's not plausible.
But
you
like,
can't do it.
Here's the thing. Like, if you're short and there's a tall girl, what are you going to do? Like,
you find her short friend.
But like,
That's what you
So you just discard the tall girls. Anyone taller than you?
No. No. You can go for tall, but you can't pretend.
That guy's grinding, right? He's not going to grind at a girl who's like way taller than him because then his hips are about like at the back for knees.
That game's not your game. You got to play a different game. You're a wine bar guy. That's what you got to do. You go to Pops down the street. You don't get into grinds or fest or club dances. Not girls taller than you. No siree, Bob. You take the volleyball team out to dinner.
Yes, right? Bro. Yes, here we go. next video. So this is a little throwback to a movie called Bird Box. So have you ever seen like Demons in the Sky? I mean, like, I haven't.
It's a very specific question, and yet no, I have not.
But these videos are dedicated to the people who see the Demons in the Sky. Videos of people on drugs always gets me.
Yeah, no, it's always funny. It cracks me up. Sometimes I don't get scared. Scared's never the right word. You know what it is? People on drugs don't talk so close to my face. That's usually my issue. I don't really care that you're on drugs. I don't care that you're talking to me. Give me like 3 inches of room. I don't need to taste the drugs you just had. I don't need a secondary contact high off your breath or your nostrils. Back the fuck up.
It's so whack.
No, dude, because it's always, and I'm shorter, so maybe it doesn't happen to you as much.
Yeah.
You get the arm around the shoulder, dude. It's like, bro, I know. You don't have to finish the sentence. I get it. I know what you're saying.
Definitely. Or like the strong grasp when you're like not even friends with them. Dude. Like
nothing makes like, you. Get the you, dude,
off
you especially,
me, bro.
I hold my breath. When someone does that to you or like too hard up like at that, I'm like, oh no, Victor's going to kill him. I literally go, oh no. I guess we got a fucking problem.
Chill.
Don't touch me. No, don't. Dude, like. Greatest movie of all time. We are your friends. Don't bro me if you don't know me.
Yes, dude. Exactly. That's what we're talking about. Next up, Nightmares Tour Bus Crest. And
crazy.
Wrecked it. The guy fell asleep while he was driving. So I actually have some insider knowledge on this. When I was at EDC Mexico, I met a guy that was on the tour bus.
Really?
That crashed. Yeah. So a bunch of people had to go to the hospital that were on the bus. They were all production guys. Broken bones, just like
that's
really
crazy.
Severe injuries. Like no one died. They said everyone was going to be okay, but yeah, severe injuries, broken bones. Like
so scary, dude. The bus looked absolutely destroyed. Hit that median thing, dude. Those are hard.
Yeah, dude. Yeah,
especially
the bus.
No one's strapped in.
No, dude.
There's loose things that could hit you
bunks.
In the head.
Everyone was in their bunks when it happened. Like
you can falls on you like equipment,
dude,
random shit.
Terrible, terrible.
Scary.
So glad everyone
T's and P's,
is gonna
dude.
Be okay.
Yeah, hope speedy recoveries to everyone. That's
speedy
so
recoveries
crazy,
to everyone.
Dude.
Exactly. Coronavirus going around right now. Ultra canceled.
Ultra
its
Abu
first
Dhabi
festival in
Abu Dhabi.
Dubai. Yeah,
I don't remember which one.
One of the Middle Eastern
makes
countries.
Sense. It's gonna be a largely an import crowd, so you don't want people traveling. I don't know though, dude. I'm nervous for spring and early summer festival season. I think Lollapalooza is safe no matter what, which is not my favorite, but arguably
why
most
do you
important.
Think it's safe no matter what?
Because it's just so late. It's after the summer. Like no matter what happens with the virus, like summertime, it gets too humid. The viruses have like a permissibility from 77% to 14% and humidity from 27% to 44%. So we're Gucci on Lollapalooza, not to get your science, but Coachella, Spring Awakening.
Dangerous.
Precarious.
Yeah, I'm honestly like, I'm not scared.
I
don't know. Is that reckless to say?
Of
is
the
it reckless to say that I'm not scared?
A virus, no. The virus is not reckless to say. As someone who's like 24, relatively healthy, like you might not even know you get it. That's how
right
it could be. But I actually am pretty worried about Coachella. I was looking up Coachella's refund policy. Like in the event of a cancellation, so I actually am pretty worried about Coachella.
Really,
dude, just
they
because
they might cancel it and not people might not get their money.
No, I don't know. It said there's no refunds, but I don't think that was that like, would, that yeah, was yeah, more yeah, of yeah. like a
no refunds, like yeah. you didn't enjoy your experience.
Yeah, or like you just if you bought it and you decide you didn't want to go, you can't return it.
Right.
But I couldn't find the cancel due to pandemic clause.
So festivals like that, they have an act of God insurance. Festivals that are like so big, so like if there's
yeah,
like
so they get paid out, so they'll get the money back. Yeah, yeah. Oh,
so like if there's something like that happens,
because God's like being a fucking dick.
That happened to Something Wicked when I went there like 5 years ago, and the entire thing got rained out.
Holy shit!
Yeah, because of a hurricane that was happening in Houston. Wow. It was like that big hurricane. I forgot what it was.
I think it was Andrew.
Maybe. I don't remember. Have no idea.
Not
but yeah, everyone got their money back because of that insurance policy. Yeah. But
wow.
Yeah.
Nice.
Speaking of other festivals, talking about Okeechobee. Okeechobee's happening next week. The police at Okeechobee are, instead of attacking the people who are doing the drugs, they're attacking or targeting the drug dealers.
They're not going out in the eyes. We have RPGs at every booth. No.
Targeting
ninja stars for throats. No, yeah, that's good. Isn't it always like that? Like, for the most part, like, they try to stop people, individuals, but really they're looking for people bringing in like a couple thousand tablets or whatever.
So I actually have this crazy story about Coachella, about my friend who got arrested. What are you doing?
I'm itching my nose, fucking asshole.
This is so weird. What is this? Who does this?
I called using the back of my thumbnails to scratch my fucking nose.
You're picking your fingers.
No, dude, I have a sliver. There's a piece of glass in my finger, and I'm going to ignore it for the sake of the pod, but know that it's bugging me. Go on with your story.
Okay, so I have this friend who was buying Molly at Coachella, and he met this drug dealer, got some like good shit, got his number. Next day, texted him again. He was like, yo, meet me in the same spot. So they go to the Dulab, meeting on the right side of the fence. And they're like, he's sitting down. He texts him. And the drug dealer comes over. And he was like, yo, what's up, man? Like, daps him up. Like, they shake hands. They're sitting down. The guy's like, yo, like, so what do you want? Like, guy goes in his bag, pulls out a fucking rock. Just, like, massive rock of Molly. And he's like, yo, lit, but like chill,
dude.
Like in the middle of Coachella, like literally
I'm trying
just
to
like,
stay on Earth, not yes. Jupiter.
And so like he gets some shit and goes, gives him the money. He grabs the pills. The guy grabs the money, and out of the crowd, two guys just start walking towards them. Right. So one guy 45 degrees, one guy 45 degrees, walking towards. The guy sees these two guys. Takes his shit, throws it in his bag, gets up, tries to split them right down the middle.
Classic.
The guy on my friend's side comes over, like fucking form tackles him, bro. Straight up linebacker, boom, crushes him.
Yes, yes.
So then the other guy jumps on his head. So then my friend's like, oh shit, like I gotta go.
I gotta cook it.
So my friend just books, and then the guy is just fucked.
Oh yeah, dude. He's out, dude. Loss
like
of 12.
6 hours later, the guy texts him. He's like, dude, fuck you for getting me arrested, you fucking narc. And my friend's like, dude, like, I'm so sorry. Like,
dude, also, fucking be more discreet, dumbass.
Literally. Couldn't have been more of the guy's fucking fault. So if you're going to Okeechobee, don't be that guy.
Keep it low.
Keep it low key if you're going to do that
and
shit.
And literally low.
Yeah.
Low.
Yeah. So.
Low. Wow. I love when people get fucking laid out at festivals. I love that shit, dude. When that security guard that works
here comes the boom.
Dude, the guy that's normally guarding like your local Family Video finally gets his shot at a teen or something. Just fucking lay the wood. Oh, I feel so good for them, dude. I just think of like old like headstrong trapped. I go, what?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yep, just there we go.
Boom. See ya. Madden title screen comes up. Hit stick lowered back at 6. Dude, I love that shit.
Exactly.
Oh, man.
One guy that actually got away from security guards was this guy who climbed into this Liquid Stranger concert. It was a sold-out concert.
Yeah.
He climbed in through this air vent or this air duct.
Yeah.
Air duct falls through. Escapes the security.
Dude.
But the security was like, you know what? Fuck it. Like, the guy climbed through an air duct. He wanted the air. We're just going to let him.
Yeah, they let him stay. Dude, yeah. He felt like eight.
Respect the will to win.
8 feet, dude. 8 feet hurts, bro. 8 feet when you're not expecting. 8 feet, like he's probably like a cat, especially like on all fours. That's gonna fucking hurt, dude. Like,
bro,
there's no
sure.
graceful landing like this. Yeah. So that was tough, but no, dude, you got at all costs, man.
It's crazy because like you hear about this shit
or
like,
$60, like you decide. I don't know.
Like, you hear about this shit like heists or yeah. like diamond heists. Like, yo, this guy's going to a fucking concert.
Have you looked at a fucking exposed duct? It's just like pressed aluminum. This shit is yeah, not steel.
No, definitely
there's,
not.
It's light and like bendy. It's meant to hold air. Like,
yeah.
It's crazy.
Very
absolutely
crazy.
Absolutely bananas. I don't think we have a cringe of the week. We'll be back next week. Markets were on fire. I had no time to curate cringes. So I couldn't even have TweetDeck open because it was sucking up all my fucking RAM.
All right. Here we go. Beats of the
week. I love a week when I could come in with some new shit and a little bit of different shit, stuff you might have missed. So very exciting. And I don't know, man. I'm sick of people. We did a rant about the music last week. We don't have to do it again.
What?
Just telling me music's good
slander?
When it's not. No, just, dude. We talked about that too.
Yeah.
But they did it again since last pod. Slander tweeted another clip like of this new track featuring whoever. Dude, how about you stop sending me out teasers? Dude, they had like 4 new songs in 2019. I went back and looked. Maybe 7. 3 of them were not good. Like, I don't understand, dude.
Yeah.
It's so frustrating.
Yeah, it really bothers you, man.
Because
it bothers me too. Because like,
it sounds awesome.
Yeah,
and they tweet
too.
So much promo for songs that
aren't out yet. Yeah. And then they come out and you're like, I've heard this promo literally a billion times, like
a year and a half.
I'm over it now. I'm over it.
I'm mad now. Now I'm mad. I'm not appreciating it because I'm mad.
Suck dummy.
And now I'm mad.
There we go. All right, here we go. This is our first song. This is Bon Appetit by Dr. Fresh featuring Chetta.
Oh. I will see Dr. Fresh in 2 weeks. He's opening for Chami.
This is some good dubstep to start us off, as always.
Always, dude. We love to start with dubstep.
All right, so our next song is Face Dip by Lingo Po Plus. I don't know. I think that's how you say his name. But this guy has under 1,000 followers on Instagram, has just over 3,000 on SoundCloud. He is going to be a major player in the bass house bass game. Like, this stuff is so good for someone that's so small.
Bold prediction.
Dude, I'm telling you, when you hear it, I don't know if you'll like it, but like, anyone who is into the underground bass scene, look this guy up. Lingo Po Plus.
Lingo Pop Plus.
I heard this EP. Like, this song is the best on the whole EP, but like, the entire EP is good. It's,
really?
Yeah. Face Strip. Here we go.
Well, I'm excited. Strap in.
Oh, it was playing at 0%. I feel like it didn't hit as hard because I was playing at... I was like, why is it going so slow? This is my bad
DJing
skills.
DJ Vic in the mix. Good, it's not
I
bad.
Swear this song's good. I almost want to redo it because it's...
Dude, this is that music I'd like to enjoy live.
Yeah, definitely. When you throw it, I don't know. In this scene, it's harder. It's way more fun to enjoy it live.
I would agree.
Yeah. All right. I'm going to switch over to... I'm trying. This is hard.
DJing in progress. Getting better, though. That's what it's about. Teamwork makes the dream work.
Yeah.
This is Weathen, Upside Down, featuring Groot Love. Just, he come out with a couple new singles that are like EDM, rock pop, rock EDM pop. Definitely outside of his normal music. But, dude, I honestly like him.
Yes, good shit. I love Group Love.
Yeah, I'm a big Group Love fan too. Definitely a summer chill banger. Something I would definitely play in a poolside mix. Definitely, especially on a Sunday. Pretty good. Glad Weathen's back with new music. His other single is absolutely terrible, though. I'm gonna shoot you straight. One before this was so bad, no cap. Do not listen to it.
You weren't a fan.
Listen to this. Not what you want.
All right. For our next song, we got Proud. We have Proud by Chami featuring Daycolm. I suck at mixing. I'm just gonna start like fading them down and then back up.
Dude, Chami's gonna get a lot of love on this podcast over the next couple weeks. That's for sure. A
lot of airtime.
First single, Ghost. Second single, Proud. I think they came out the same day. Both good. And then we got another Chami-produced single coming up in a minute. But so good. This is a big year. He's got his full album coming out. I'm fucking excited for him. I'm excited for Mala. I think they've been holding back. They've been touring a lot, mixing shows live. I hope and I know that they're going to put out a lot of good music in 2019, dude. The way the music is going is more towards their sound, too. Like, it really is.
Definitely.
Like, definitely bass. Club, bass, house. Rave music. Not a lot of dubstep. I haven't heard a ton of dance pop at all this year.
Yeah, I like the song.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's going to be a big year for Chami. Calling it.
All right. So our next song is one of Disclosure's new songs. This one is Expressing What Matters.
Oh, my God, dude. You want to have a fun on an EP, listening to an EP? Play this shit on repeat. I love every song on it, but, you know, Expressing What Matters. Oh, it's so good. So good, dude. They're back, baby. And they said they're going to take a break. More new music coming out in 2 weeks. I hope.
Really?
Yeah, I hope we get to see him at Coachella. I'm praying for it, dog. But they're back, and this music is awesome. The whole EP is good, dude. There's one song that I'm kind of mids on, but the rest of it, unbelievable, dude. I don't even know what genre it is. Honestly don't. It's electronic. It's a little bit of, like, African tribal music, dude. A lot of disco, a little bit of a disco-y pop sound to some
disco,
of it.
Disco, baby.
Every single is different. Man, it's just so good. It's just so good. Second drop. Here we go. Oh, it's amazing. Amazing. Up next.
The vibes.
A second Disclosure track. You want to talk about, like, honestly, I have no idea what genre this is. Okay, electronic, African. Like, I've been able to stop singing this song for the last, like, 10 days straight. Tondo, Disclosure. Unbelievable. Second favorite song on the whole album. Ready? The horns.
Bring disco back, baby.
I love the chorus, dude. I don't know what the words are, but you just sing along anyways. Ready? Hup, hup. Hey. A little bit of tropical flavor. What a comeback, dude. To be gone for 5 years, come back with some way new sound, and it hits so hard, dude. And there's another one that's way more dance EDM-y. Ecstasy, that's great. But these are definitely my two favorite tracks off the album, off the EP for sure. I'm excited for more music from them in 2 weeks, so hopefully we get it. We'll see how it goes.
Definitely.
My last song, okay, Lady Gaga pop hit. You know, you don't need me for these picks.
No.
False start on me next.
Yeah. So next song, we got Drown by Martin Garrix featuring Clinton Kane. So this is a little dance pop song.
Yeah. Sounds like a Avicii Kygo.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely Avicii Kygo song. We love Avicii and we love Kygo.
I I actually like this song a lot too. And I shit on Martin Garrix, but I like this song.
I know, I was gonna say, you're a Martin Garrix hater.
Yeah, good dance pop. Not a lot of dance pop this year though.
No.
Not even like there's bad dance pop, like there's no dance pop.
That's kind of how I'm feeling, right?
Yeah, I don't hate it. Although, as you know, the absolute slapperoni, dude. Lonely Joel Corey still goes. So that song still goes. I can't wait to listen to that when it's actually warm outside. Oh, I can't wait.
All right, here we go.
Last
with,
up, Lady Gaga, new hit, Stupid Love. Produced, beats by Chami. Love it. Excited.
Yeah, you like the song?
Oh, it's so good, dude. Music video looks awesome, too, for big music video people. Entire music video shot on an iPhone. She does have other well-known EDM producers producing the other tracks on the album, which comes out in April. So I don't remember off the top of my head who's who, but expect more EDM beats from her.
I like this. I like
it
a lot.
I know, dude. It's good. It's actually good. I'm excited for the remix pack on this single. Yeah, I don't know, dude. We talked about it at the beginning of the year. The return of, like, acid house, 90s warehouse rave music, and a little bit of disco.
Yeah.
We called it kind of at the beginning of the year. Like, that's the sound. And, dude, I think we've been spot on so far, right?
Totally agree.
Everything from Calvin Harris to Diplo's new sound, Disclosure yeah. with the surprise music, like, nailing it on the head.
Seeing the trends before they happen.
That's why we're here, you know. Dude. That's why we're here.
Yeah.
Oh, so all good. Right,
so next song is a little throwback, a little remix. It's the All-American Rejects, Dirty Little Secret, remixed by Skull Kids.
I love this song so much.
You know, amazing song. You listen to this song, it just brings you back to like 6th grade, 7th grade.
I sang this 2 weekends ago at a karaoke bar in Montreal, much to the chagrin of local French Canadians, right in their faces.
These are also up-and-coming guys, small guys, yeah. Skull Kids.
Dude,
yeah.
The last chorus on this, where she feels it so. I love that song. Oh, hell yeah. Dude, I'm going to put this out there right now. We put this on a summer playlist. This is gonna, every girl is going to ask you what this song is. This is a girl favorite, a female-friendly hit.
Definitely.
100%.
Definitely.
I could already tell. Like, Gabby Palumbo's going to text me after a party on this song. Like, what was that All-American Rejects? And I'm going to say, watch the fucking pod, and then you'd know.
Here we go.
As a treat, watch the pop.
Here we go. That's it for the beats of the week today.
Hell yeah,
we had
dude.
Nine solid beats. Louis the Child comes out with some new music tomorrow. So
with who's it with?
I don't know who.
Dude, Foster the People. There it
oh,
is.
Oh yes.
Foster the People.
I knew this.
So, I'm telling you, this is gonna be a breakout. This is another breakout year for EDM. I think this year we're going to get some big pop, rock, we've had already country collabs with EDM producers. Mm. I think everything is starting to sound a little like dance music, which isn't a bad thing. I'm a fan of it, especially in the charts because there's more money in music videos. There's more money in touring. Guess what, dude? People want to go out and see dance music live. 100%.
100%.
Especially younger people, right? So just can another one of the long list of collabs between producers. Pop stars, dude. I absolutely love it. I can't wait.
Exciting.
I think the song might be a little too chill for me. If I had to guess, I had to put a guess out there in the universe, but I guess we'll find out.
I've been loving their new sounds lately. Like Free, amazing.
Yeah, good. I was a little disappointed with the show they put on at Aragon last year that we saw, but you know, we'll bounce back. But
yeah.
What else do we got coming up?
That's it. I got Santa Fe, New Mexico this weekend. Going to Meow Wolf on Thursday.
Wow.
So stoked for that. If you don't know Meow Wolf, they're a art collective in Santa Fe, New Mexico.
Oh, dude, I love
Look
Santa
Look them
Fe.
Up. Super, super cool. So I'm stoked to be reporting that back next week.
Yeah.
Here on
dude,
the pod.
Santa Fe's amazing. I went at the end of the year last year. It was awesome.
Yeah.
Dude,
so Santa Fe, San Francisco and Denver are the three shows that we're doing this
weekend.
Nice,
dude. Just don't get a coronavirus.
Yeah, dude. I'll watch out.
Wash your hands, people. PSA.
Wash your hands. Wash your hands. Subscribe to our pod if you're not subscribed already.
Yep.
Like us.
Yep.
Tell your friends.
Review, share. Share links.
Yes. There you go. All right. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next week on the rail. Bye. See ya.